How to update WordPress manually. The first rule in updating any content management system, like WordPress, is to have a backup of your website and database. To do this, you have two choices. The first is to make a backup with a third-party utility, like a plugin. Or, you can go to the cPanel of your website, and there you have the ability to backup your site. In fact, this second choice is the best way to interact with your website, because it's where you find everything related to your website, is the web hosting control panel. But, if you prefer go with a plugin, follow this procedure. From the dashboard of the WordPress, go to Plugins, Add New. Now, to search for plugins based with this criteria, type the word backup and choose one from the available plugins, like the online backup for WordPress. Click to install now. Then activate plugin. Next, in the plugins page, go to the online backup for WordPress plugin and click on View Dashboard and go to Backup to create a new fresh backup. Set the backup type to local, database and file system. And start the manual backup. Now just wait until the backup completes, and then you can download the backup files to your machine. It's also much easier if you go to your cPanel of your website hosting service. Search for the files section and click on backups. And then you can generate a new fresh backup. And provide them available to download. Next, we need to download the last version of WordPress. Go to wordpress.org and get the last version. Next, prepare to upload, delete WP content folder. Unzip and open the WordPress.zip file. And delete the WP content folder. Next, uploading and updating WordPress. First from cPanel, Hosting Control Panel, go to File Manager. Type your credentials, username and password. Now go to public HTML folder. And go to where you install your WordPress. In my case, a subdirectory called home. Next, delete all files and folders, except WP content folder and wp-config.php file. Click to delete and confirm. And remember that we can do this from a local file manager. Now if you go to your website and refresh the page, you realize that all files have been deleted. Now, what we need to do is uploading the new files. But first, we can see on how we can make all of this from a local file manager. I'm using Coda, but you can choose others, like CyberDoc, for Mac, FileZilla, or SmartFTP for Windows. For FTP logins and upload details, go to your host control panel, and there you find all details needed to add into your local file manager. After that, you just have to connect into the server where your site is hosted, and navigate to the public folder to delete and upload the new files. Now, with all files deleted, we need to make the upload. Go to where you previously unzipped the WordPress folder, and upload all files to the server, except the WP content folder, into public HTML, and into the subdirectory. In this case, to public HTML, home. Then, with all files in place, you may have to delete some default.php file. If in any case you go to your website address and find a page like this one, all you have to do is to return to your file manager and under public HTML folder, Delete this default.php file. Next, return to your site and refresh the page. Enter to where you installed WordPress. Refresh again, or click where it says to update. Now update WordPress database. And your WordPress database was successfully updated. And this is how you update your site with the new content management system, like WordPress.